All right, looks like it's time to get started. Hi, everyone, and welcome to this presentation, Course Authoring with the Generator, and how to properly scale your online training. My name is Jamie Newman, Marketing Manager with Global eTraining, and we're joined today by Steve Wenzel, Chairman and CTO of Global eTraining, to talk about how successful online training providers, successful software developers and SaaS businesses, how they are really capitalizing on what I'll call an optimistic mindset in consideration of how the global landscape of work, especially within the AEC industry, within the BIM world, is changing. COVID-19 has changed the way that many of us do work in this industry, and we're continuing to see a new normal solidifying with more and more work being done remotely from home offices. As such, companies in the corporate training world, software providers, SaaS businesses, these companies are recognizing the opportunities to do business better through scaling the ways that they provide training for their clients. And so today, Steve is going to show us why now is a critical time to consider scaling your business through course authoring. And perhaps most importantly, he's going to be sharing how to make good technology decisions when it comes to selecting a platform. And of course, he'll also do a live demo of our course authoring technology, the Generator. Final point, if you are looking to scale your business, you'll notice that Steve is going to be sharing his contact information shortly. So you'll be able to reach out directly to him for a personal walkthrough of our course authoring solutions for corporate training companies, consultants, and software providers. So be sure to jot down his email address, his contact information. With all that said, let's jump into today's presentation, Course Authoring with the Generator. Over to you, Steve.
Hi, everybody. Thanks so much for joining me on today's webinar, Course Authoring with the Generator. I'm Steve Wenzel. I'm CTO and Chairman of Global eTraining. And I certainly think course authoring is a very important topic, particularly right now with everybody trying to figure out how to educate and train a virtual workforce. So I certainly hope you find this presentation educational and you learn a lot. But if you do have questions throughout, as Jamie mentioned previously, we do have a chat available. It should be in the right-hand corner of your screen, but I'll also be able to be contacted afterwards at steveW@globaletraining.ca and on my personal direct number. Those details will be coming up shortly in the presentation. So without further ado, let's jump in.
So the presentation is going to be split into two parts. The first part, going to be walking through a bit of a PowerPoint presentation. And then the second half, we're going to be jumping into a live demonstration of the product. Throughout this, I'm going to help you kind of walk through a step-by-step guide of how to make a decision, is online training correct for you, and how to get started, with step one being, why is training the right route for you to go with? Help you understand some of the common pitfalls of course authoring, because it's often only after you've developed your course and rolled it out that you suddenly realize, I wish somebody had told me some of these pitfalls before I'd spent the time building the course. We're going to have a little look at a few of the different alternative types between live virtual classrooms and asynchronous self-paced software options. And then, of course, we're going to actually jump into a product demo of the Generator as developed by Global eTraining. Now, I know some people often jump off webinars early, so if that is the case and you do want to get in contact with me, my contact information is at the bottom there, steveW@globaletraining.ca, and you can also contact me on 780-819-9819, and I'll happily answer any additional questions that you have. So please don't hesitate to reach out to me during or after this presentation. But before I jump into step one, I think it's important that I just highlight what we believe and why we've asked you to come here and why you've joined us, the key differentiators of the Generator as a software are over all the other course authoring solutions that you have the ability to choose from. And I'm going to run through these and you're both here and throughout the demo. So firstly, the ability to be able to make attractive looking content with ease, not having to redesign templates from scratch, which requires a graphics degree, but actually being able to create attractive looking content with ease and be able to maintain design consistency across when you have lots of authors developing content for you. If you have 10 different people creating content and all 10 courses look and feel different, your learners will say, what is this all about? So being able to create consistent designs within your content. And those two things, good looking content, consistency of content, as well as having multiple learning styles and engaging content, is what helps drive learner adoption of your content, helps people actually stay within the course. And of course, you can quickly update and edit your content in real time with the generator. So if you work in, let's say, a software company, and on a weekly basis you're releasing updates, you'll probably have to update your course on a weekly basis too. And what you don't want to do is go through a painful process of updating that content for your learners and having to upload files into your learning management system so that your learners can get access to it. But with the generator, we make it so that you can simply update your course and roll it out to tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of learners if required, on multiple different learning management systems in multiple different languages. We also know it's important for engagement that people can build custom learning paths, either bookmarking or based on skills gap assessments. What I mean by that, take an exam, you fail a question. What's the learning objective from that piece of knowledge that I obviously didn't know? And can you give me a custom learning path based off what I don't know? And in the generator, we're absolutely able to build those things. We also believe in micro-credentialing and being able to take content that you've already created, either from one course or from multiple courses, and through a simple drag and drop, you can dice and splice courses in any different array and be able to build lots of micro-courses from your existing content without having to recreate that content from scratch every time you wish to leverage it in a different course. And lots of companies have already created tons of PowerPoints or PDFs or documents that, again, you're using in the classroom or you're using in your virtual classrooms. But again, how about the fact that using the generator, you can take those PowerPoints, you can upload them into the generator and turn them into actual trackable online content where you can track engagement of that PowerPoint. And you can do the same if you've previously created content in a popular tool, Adobe Captivate. It's a popular authoring tool. You could certainly take your Adobe Captivate content and upload that to the generator and be able to take advantage of a lot of the great features of the generator that aren't available inside of Adobe Captivate. So we're not asking you to recreate the wheel all of the time. And something that's extremely important, you'll see, I'll bring this up in one of the in step two, the pitfalls. Lots of people forget that they might have to host content on lots of different learning management systems. You may have a learning management system in your company, but if you have customers, remember, all of your customers may have their own learning management system. And then if you have individual learners, they may not have a learning management system. So you might have to host your content on your own learning management system and the learning management systems of your customers. Now, if that's the case, you really want to be able to send it out to them and be able to upload it to the learning management system without losing control of your data or without losing control of your content, because your content is your IP. So it's important that you can upload it and stay in control of your content no matter what the learning management system is. It's also important that you can get data analytics back from those learning management systems. If you're creating your content and not hosting it on your own learning management system, you would lose all the data in traditional course authoring tools. But with the generator, we pull all of that data and provide you beautiful Power BI dashboards so that you can actually see the data and see how people are engaging with your course content. And we can do that in multiple languages to enable you to be global, accommodate the needs of your workforce, and provide immediate scalability out of your content. So that's a little bit about the generator, so that you know what's coming up later on the later in the presentation. But now we'll jump into step one of why should you invest in online training? And first and foremost, immediate access to information. If it's right there for your staff, for you to be able to get immediate access to information, is a huge motivator. And it really helps you manage your internal knowledge. Particularly right now, there's a lot of people moving between companies, layoffs, et cetera, et cetera. And if you lose that valuable knowledge out of your company, that's very, very costly to a business. So to be able to capture that And then disseminate that information throughout your organization and have that on hand at any point is extremely valuable. The ROI on that is huge. And it also makes it a cost-effective way to be able to roll out training. You haven't got to get lots of people into a room. You haven't got to fly people around around the world to be able to bring expensive instructors in to be able to teach and hope that that knowledge is passed. It's a cost-effective way to be able to say, you've got the internet, you've got a computer, here's access to your training. Lots of customers use this, lots of companies use this for their employee onboarding. Certainly Globally Training leverages this ourselves, and we create content and exams that people can actually look at and go through before they actually start with the business, so that when they do start, day one is already a productive day, not trying to teach them about the company necessarily. And it certainly helps with employee engagement. It's been said that the number one thing that people and staff want inside of companies is a company that invests in their own future education and training them. And so this is a huge employee engagement tool. I've mentioned it before, but data is so important. Understanding how learners are engaging with your content is key. If I'm in a classroom and I've got an instructor talking to me, or if I'm in a virtual classroom and somebody is talking to me, it is almost impossible to track engagement with that content and understand what you're absorbing and what you are not. But with online training, you can see every single click, every single piece that they're engaging with, and make sure that you're tracking data so you can help either improve the quality of your course or understand learners that are struggling so you can help bring them up to the standard that you want and actually offer them support. And this, of course, helps with team productivity, knowing that people are engaging with the content, learning the content. Everyone's going to be at the same baseline level of knowledge. But also, if I'm struggling with something at work, generally, I'm going to reach out and ask my colleague next to me and ask them for help, which means two of us are no longer being productive versus being able to go on my course, searchable resource, right available at my fingertips that I could actually ask. Quite important in this day and age, environmental sustainability. If we're flying people all the way around the world to be able to train each other and be able to make classrooms, not environmentally sustainable. I know we're not doing a lot of that right now, but certainly online training is an extremely green solution to education. And staff morale, I've mentioned, this is one of the leading things inside of companies on multiple surveys that are actually increasing morale that staff are asking for is companies that invest in their online, on their ongoing education. And this is a very scalable way of being able to do that, because you could train one person, you could train 100,000 people. It really doesn't matter. And you can train them in multiple languages all at the same time. And with online education, you can easily update and disseminate that information without having to fly instructors around, as I've mentioned before. So if you are, again, using the example of the SaaS software company that requires to train somebody on an important update and train all your customers on an important update that just came out, well, guess what? You can easily update your content and disseminate that information using online training. And one of the things that would be really important to me is that I can learn at my pace, not at the pace of my classmates. I found that very frustrating during my educational career, certain subjects were either going way too fast for me, and other things were going way too slow. I want to be able to study those things I'm struggling at slower, and those things that I grasp really easy, I can go forward. But if I sit in a classroom, I have to go at the pace of everybody else in the classroom. So hopefully that tells you a few of the reasons, which you may have already known about, of why go with online training. But now let's talk a little bit about some of the common pitfalls of online training. Things that I wish people had told me when we started Globally Training, because we've made probably all of these mistakes, hence why we built the generator, is to overcome those mistakes. So my team takes forever to build content. If you've got somebody with knowledge, they want to be able to put that knowledge into an online training tool extremely easy. But if you're using complicated software, you've got to learn that software. And then if you're not using it every day, then you forget how to use that software. Then if you haven't got templates, you've got to design a template. And all of a sudden, you're starting to get a committee of graphic designers, online educators. You get a committee that has to be able to approve the curriculum, design the curriculum, quality control, roll it out, learning management system. Now you need technology people. So all of a sudden, this simple task becomes very expensive and very time consuming for the poor person that you just said, in your spare time, would you mind building a quick course? Which is generally how we ask people to go about building content. And then that poor person ends up taking all of their weekends and evenings to build some content. And our training doesn't have a consistent look and feel is something I hear a lot. Learners like to see a consistent look and feel throughout all of their content because then they have familiarity with it. They know what they're expecting. When they go into one of your courses, it's going to work the exact same way as all the other courses. And something we also hear, courses are boring. Video only is often something that we see. And if you are not a visual learner, if you don't learn by watching, then you're not going to absorb any of that information. Actually, only about 3% of us do learn through watching videos, which is a very small percentage of us. Most people require multiple learning styles. So that's the audio, the practical example, the reading, the watching, the doing, the playing, the exams. So courses are often boring. I mean, the generator does enable you to make video only content because it is extremely quick to be able to get that information out. But we also really strongly encourage you to be able to build engaging content touching on multiple learning styles. And something that I have briefly touched on, but the need to host on more than one learning management system. People always overlook this. They go, hey, well, I've bought a learning management system, or I've downloaded a learning management system. But then what happens if you need to load onto more than one learning management system because your customer says, hey, I don't want to have to single sign on into your platform as well. Or, hey, I'm not getting my staff to log into yet another system. I want to host it on my own learning management system. And this is a very, very common trend, particularly right now where almost every customer owns a learning management system of some sort. If you're creating content, the chances are you'll need to put it on multiple learning management systems simultaneously, and you really don't want to lose control of your intellectual property to somebody else's learning management system. But with the generator, you're able to do that without losing any control of your content. Now, if we're going to roll training out, most companies have people that speak multiple different languages. And whilst we might have a predominant language, it's often nice to be able to translate, but it costs so much money. And if you do not have a good translation tool built within the software, which most do not, then translation is extremely expensive, limiting the level of scalability that you have, and will cost you a fortune if you really want to be able to do it. So think about which languages you want before embarking on an online training journey. And lots of people don't realize that they have to even buy a learning management system. If you're not familiar with what a learning management system is, it's essentially the platform that you build your courses in, an authoring tool. You have to upload those to a learning management system because that is where the learner will log in to be able to access your courses, and you'll be able to see the data about what that learner is doing. And if you hadn't thought through that, now you're in for a real sticker shock if you have to then go buy a learning management system. And often, most people have created a ton of content already. They've already created PowerPoints, already created PDFs. So why not be able to give you the tools to be able to leverage those, which again, the generator does enable you to do. Leverage those PowerPoints, leverage those PDFs, and put them into a course automatically just by uploading them, which then be hosted on a learning management system and provide you the data about how people are engaging with those PowerPoints or those PDFs. And something else that people don't really think about is if you take a course and you upload it to a learning management system, the data that you get out of learning management systems is learner-based. It's telling me, how has John done? How has Sally done? But it's not telling me, how engaging is my course? Where are the flaws in my course? Which courses are most popular? So that is course analytics versus learner analytics. And again, through the generator, we really try to provide you course analytics so you can understand the engaging nature of your content. And right now, COVID, in all honesty, it requires us all, if we're doing any form of teaching, to teach virtually. And we really would like to be able to track that engagement, but it's very, very difficult to be able to do that virtually. Right now, I think you're paying attention, but I don't know that 100%. So how can I track engagement with Zoom virtual training meetings or GoToMeeting or WebEx or Google Hangouts? So again, with online training tools, Now that we are required to be able to teach and train a virtual workforce while working from home, we need to be able to understand the engagement and what people are actually doing with our content. And one of the final parts, I use the same content in lots of different courses. So Globally Training does this a lot. We create content and then we dice and splice it and we mix and mash it, and you know, we can create a whole new learning path. But in a lot of authoring tools, you have to recreate that content time and time again, which makes it very, very inefficient. So we like to give you the tools to actually enable you to leverage existing content over and over and over in multiple courses. So I thought this was a nice quote from the CEO and co-founder of LearnWorlds, that just throwing a video or a PDF at someone and considering this to be e-learning doesn't cut it anymore. Users demand great aesthetics, outstanding design and topography, and expertly designed user journeys. Investing in the design of your online school and learning content is not a luxury, but a necessity. And I don't think there's ever been a truer word said. And I've mentioned this before, but I think it's always worth reiterating. You can help your people get what we call get what matters, which is access to the content, without the expensive venues, without the expensive travel, without the exorbitant training fees of having to have instructors coming into a classroom, and without the distractions, i.e. that you don't have to actually leave your job for 3 days to go to a three-day training course. Very, very easily, and pretty much you could start with this tomorrow. So step three, the common alternatives to face-to-face training. And there's three different sets of examples I'm going to give you here. So firstly, we've got the virtual classrooms, the Zoom, the Google Meetings, the Cisco WebEx, the GoToMeetings. And they're popular for very good reasons. They replicate instructor-led training quite well. You actually get that human interaction. So it's something that's very familiar with us, that we can actually feel like we're engaging with a human interaction with a human being. I can ask questions, etc. So that's why they're popular. And it allows me to be quite flexible with the content. You ask a question, I can answer that and educate the group on the fly. But they do have shortcomings. Firstly, they've got to be scheduled. You had to show up to this webinar today at this exact time. If you couldn't make it, you would miss it. So they do have to be scheduled, and it does require you actually leaving your workforce as a group to be able to come to a virtual class. Mentioned it before, I still think it's really important. No learner engagement tracking. I don't know who's paying attention and who's not. Who's checking their email and who's listening intently. And who's absorbing what and who's not absorbing stuff. Often presentations can be long and boring. And they're expensive because you do, whilst the software and the platform may be cheap, you do still require that actual instructor, which is an expensive person, to be able to teach that content over and over again. So then that moves us on, if we're not going with the virtual class, it moves us on to the common authoring tools. There's two big players here, Adobe Captivate and Articulate. And they're popular for, again, very good reasons. They're the Photoshop of course development. And if you don't know what I mean by that, Photoshop. Super complicated piece of software that has an unbelievable amount of tools. Now, if you're a professional photographer and use it every day, it's an extremely powerful tool. But if you're like me and like to take photos with your iPhone, there's a reason why the editing tools on an iPhone are popular. It's because I can quickly edit a photo and make it look much better than when I just took it without having to learn Photoshop and use it every day. So there are a huge array of templates, millions of features, and they do work on multiple learning management systems. So that's, again, why they're popular, the variety, the flexibility that you have. But again, as I mentioned, their shortcomings. It is the Photoshop. That's why it's a shortcoming. You get choice paralysis. If you have multiple authors, many people are going to create things to look and feel different. If you don't really know how to use the software, it's probably going to come with bugs, mistakes, interactions that you didn't even know that you'd added in. If you do put your content on somebody else's learning management system, how are you going to push an update? You're going to have to republish the course every time you update your content and provide your customer with a new SCORM file, which is what the published courses are called. And then once your course is hosted by your client, you have no control over that content. Now they have access to your IP and you do not have the ability to remove it from them. And you also don't have any control over your data because you don't know what's happening on their learning management system because you don't have access to it. You also can't translate on the fly without having to go through expensive translation procedures. And it's highly expensive because you do require the software. You require somebody who knows how to use the software. You require a learning management system to host the courses. And you require your authors, etc., which you require in all of your different types of course authoring tools. So then we've got commonly used distribution platforms, which you may or may not have heard of. Companies like Thinkific or Teachable, again, they're popular because they're fairly easy to author on. They are cloud-based tools. They provide nice templates. So they're fairly easy to author in. And you can distribute your content to via the learning management system. You provide a learning management system along with it. So that makes it quite nice. They're collaborative. You can have multiple people authoring at the same time. And you do get fairly good data analytics out of that learning management system. But the shortcomings are, if you want to update your content, again, you can only push that content to the learning management system that's been provided to you by the company. That's how they keep you locked in. So if you want to do your update, you can only update onto the learning management system, which you have been provided as part of your subscription. They only have one learning management system. So if you want to start hosting on a variety of different platforms, you're kind of stuck. You can't do your quick and easy translations. And once you've built on these platforms, extremely difficult to get off. So you're fairly locked in. So this brings us to the generator. And through the course of this presentation, I've highlighted a lot of the shortcomings, a lot of the pitfalls. And hopefully you've picked up that the reason I've highlighted these is through the history of Globally Training, when we first started this 15 years ago, these were all the mistakes and shortcomings that we found and that we had to overcome. And the best way for us to do this was to build the generator, build our own tool, which overcame all of these issues and enabled Globally Training to grow to the company it is today, with hundreds of courses, tens of thousands of learners in over 35 countries, with thousands of customers. So to give you the generator in a nutshell, it's a collaborative cloud-based course authoring technology enabling organizations to create, customize, license, share, and organize your content across any learning management system in any language. We've developed it because our customer base are architecture, engineering, construction, and manufacturing firms. And we've thought about, how do you centralize, customize, and enhance your employee training programs? And how can you take your training global? Because a lot of the firms are global, with multi-language translation. We've thought about it for software developers and SaaS businesses. Drive adoption, engagement, and retention through custom training, and quickly enable updates to roll out to your clients on any new features without painful, time-consuming sending files off to different customers. We've thought about this from corporate training company perspective, which need to be able to scale out of classroom training through a cloud-based online training solution, which you can actually monitor, measure, and report on to help make sure that your content is engaging and giving your learners the experience that they want, and that your learners are going to be able to perform off the back of your training. And we've also thought about this for educational institutions, which right now, particularly right now, need to rapidly convert traditional course content into interactive online education. And the course's content could be used in a blended learning strategy, where you can still have an instructor on hand to be able to answer questions, but the students can be going through things self-paced and ask the questions when they need them, versus having the instructor teaching. And then the students go home going, I wish I had somebody that I could ask questions to. So with the generator, I'm going to be jumping into a demo here pretty shortly. Flexible LMS hosting, automatic updates of your content, detailed reporting and dashboards, multiple learner interfaces so that the learner can pick and choose their experience, the ability to do micro-credentialing so you can slice and dice your content into micro-courses so that people can actually make progress in smaller bite-sized sections. Skills gap assessments enabling you to build custom learning paths based off questions that they didn't know the answer to, and only given them access to content that they don't actually evidently know because they failed the question. Capabilities to translate. Integrations into Captivate and PowerPoint so you can leverage existing content that you've already created. Collaborate across multiple authors. Leverage that existing content that you've already created so again you can splice and dice your content as you see fit. You can custom brand it, and I think most importantly, you have complete control over your content in one central location through the generator. So now I'm going to be jumping into a product demo, and I'm going to bring the generator in here and show you it live. And as you can see, I've already started creating a course called Course Authoring with the Generator. I'm going to use this one in my example. So to build a course, we break it down to five simple steps: course overview, branding, build your course, publish your course, and translate. I'll skip through these fairly quickly. Course overview, give it a title, link to a help desk or a support email so that people can ask questions if they have questions about your course. Give it a short description and a long description. We could brand the content to give you your logo, course image, and your company colors. And then we get into step three, which is the crux of it, building your course, which is where I'm going to spend most of my time. So as you can see, I started building this course earlier, and I've fleshed out quite a bit of content. But now I want to start adding some more content to it. So I'm going to add a new lecture, and I'll call it lecture. I'm going to add a new topic, and I'm going to call it topic. And I'm going to add a new slide, and I'm going to call it slide. If I come in and edit the slide, I can start adding content to my course. So I start off by adding my text, giving the learner something to read. Now we want to be sure that we are giving the learners multiple learning styles so that those that read, read, those that listen, listen, those that watch, watch, etc., etc. So I've added my text, now I can add my audio. And I can upload an audio recording. I'm not going to do that live. It takes too long, but I can upload my audio right here. Then we've got these placeholders around the side where I can simply drag and drop from the tiles on the right. I can drag Let Me Tries or PDFs or practical examples we use these for. If we edit, we can either link to PDFs or files that you have on your own servers, SharePoint, Dropbox, Box. Or you can select a file and upload it. I could drag in what we call Learn Mores or breakout sessions where I can create text and audio or an additional slideshow so that learners can click on this and be taken into additional content. I can upload pictures and images. And if I jump into browsing the server, I can see all the pictures that have previously been uploaded in my course so I can re-leverage pictures that I've already uploaded. And we work to keep your files nice and neat and organized and split them into images, audio, video, documents, and other. So this picture has already been uploaded into this course, so I'm going to use that again. I can drag in my videos or e-demos, where again I can link out to something like YouTube or SharePoint, or I can upload my own video. And then finally, I have eTips, which are tips and tricks, a little additional tools. So this is a tip. Now I should have text, audio, video, breakout sessions, images, practical examples. And if I preview this, I can see what it's going to look like. So I didn't add much content, but I can see this is my text. I can click on my tip and say, this is a tip. I can click on my picture and I can see the image that I uploaded. And if we look at a slide that's been built out a little bit more, see a bit more content. So here we have text, we have the audio, we have the images. We can jump through, we can see some learn mores. So a bit of a breakout session again with audio included. We can see videos that can play. We also see access to this question mark here, which would take us to the help desk. So if I click that, it would go either to the support email or the help desk that you have allocated. So you can see it's super quick and easy to be able to add content and keep building that content out. Now, if you don't want all of the content to be into that interactive format, into that, that certain layout, we can add different types of media. So instead of adding a slide, which is what I just did, we could add different media, such as a video and just have videos, or PDFs and just have PDFs. Or I mentioned before, we can add PowerPoints and have PowerPoints. And this is what it looks like if you add a PowerPoint. So here's a PowerPoint that I added earlier. If I preview that, you should recognize this if you are paying attention. It's the PowerPoint that we just went through. And so I've been able to upload a PowerPoint and turn a PowerPoint into an interactive piece of content that can work in a learning management system. When I say work in a learning management system, here's what I mean. So this is my learning management system up here. And here's the course that I uploaded. If I click resume and open it up. Now that course is playing inside of my learning management system so that every interaction I have with this course is saved by the learning management system. So it knows that I'm looking at this content. It knows that I'm watching a video so that I can report on it because data and analytics are really, really important. It knows that I'm watching these images and clicking on these breakout sessions. And then I'm listening to the audio. And I can get access to my help desk. It's also tracking what I'm doing. So as I'm making my way through, it shows check marks. But as a learner, maybe I want to bookmark something. So I want to add this content and bookmark it and save it for later. So I'm going to add this content to my custom learning path. And you'll see that it appears under my custom learning path. And I can also check this filter. And I can whittle this course just down to the videos. So if I just want to watch the videos and quickly get through the content, I could just watch the videos that are available in this course. And I can turn these filters on and off. So extremely powerful for me to be able to personalize this course. One, down to my learning style. Secondly, down to the content that I want to save. Thirdly, maybe I just want to look at the videos. So we talked about the custom learning path, and that's where the quizzes come into play. I've built a quiz here previously. If I hit edit, you'll notice that I can certainly give it a title, some text, a pass mark, but I can show objectives. And that means that if you fail a question, I can link it to a learning objective already built into the course. So here's a question, and I can select, and I say, if you get this question wrong, add slides or add PowerPoints to my custom learning path. So it's building me a custom learning path based off the knowledge that I don't have. So that's massively powerful for those skill gap assessments. Now I want to draw your attention to the fact that this has two main lectures, building the course and adding the PowerPoint. And if I look in here, you'll notice it's got building the course and adding a PowerPoint. But it's really important to know that you can add additional content and easily roll that out to your learners, no matter which learning management system they're on. So I'm going to show you two quick things. One, I'm going to open up my public course catalog. So we have two catalogs here, my catalog and the public catalog. Public catalog being a collection of publicly available content that you can leverage, and my catalog being a collection of the courses that your organization has personally built. Now, I'd like to add another lecture or topic from the public course catalog into my course. So I like the look of this content, and I'm going to drag this in, and I'm going to add it right here into my learning path. So I can leverage any content that I've previously made, and I can dice and splice my courses, reorganize them, move them around as I see fit, and build other courses from existing content. So I've just added that. Now, if I come down to publication, I can have the option to republish this course, which I'm going to do. Hit republish, accept my terms and conditions. takes a second to process. Now, when I come back into my learning management system and hit refresh, I'm going to resume my course. You're going to notice that the content that I just added, which was before you build your course, has now been added to my learning path and is available right inside of the learning management system, so that you can quickly make updates to your content and you can quickly roll that content out to learning management systems. And it's not just one learning management system. If you have content on 50 different learning management systems and you republished, that content would simultaneously roll out to those learning management systems, and I didn't have to upload a single file or distribute a single piece of content to those learning management systems to get it to display. So that's massively, massively powerful and really, really efficient. So the final part, step five, languages. We can translate into over 20 different languages. All you need to do is let us know which language you'd like, and we can translate it into any of them, and it will process in just a couple of hours. Now, what does this look like for the learner? Let's jump into a course that has been translated. I'm going to open this up. And you'll notice that this course is already in a different language. It's not in English, it's in Spanish. And if I want to switch from Spanish to German, the learner has the option to do that. The more courses you translate, the bigger the drop-down list, and the learner can pick and choose the language of their choice, and now the content is in German. And if I want to go back to English, I can simply select English, and now we're back in English. So, super efficient, easy to translate, easy to update content, easy to leverage content from already published content, whether it's your own personal content that's private to your organization, or whether it's content that's publicly available via the public course catalog. All the content is published in consistent format with a consistent template, leveraging multiple learning styles from text, audio, tips, images, videos. And it's all saved in one central location so you can have multiple people collaborating on the course in real time. One of the most important things as well is the data. Now, this is a snapshot of data that we have pulled, showing us the year 2020 from January and February. We've applied the filters. On the learning management system, www.globallytraining.net. Now, we're only displaying one learning management system. If this content was hosted on multiple learning management systems, we could show any of the learning management systems where this content is hosted, or all of the learning management systems where this content is hosted, showing how many learners are accessing, how many courses have been accessed, how many hours of training have been taken within this learning management system. We can look at the number of courses by month, or number of the topics accessed, or number of hours spent training by month. We can also see the most popular courses, and we can drill down into any one of these. So if I want to look at February, I can click on February. And if I just want to see what has happened in the most popular course in February, I can select this course as well. And I can drill down into the minute pieces of detail. So it doesn't matter where your content is hosted. That data is provided back to you so you can see how people are leveraging it and utilizing it, which is so powerful. So I hope you found this presentation useful and informative. I hope if you get anything, you learn from some of the mistakes that I made once upon a time. But I certainly hope that you see the generator as the powerful tool that we found it. And if you're looking at either getting into online training, converting content into online training, leveraging your existing resources and making those into online training, or any form of online training that you need to do, I hope you see the generator as a tool that can give you a solution that lots of the solutions out there can't. And if you do have follow-up questions, by all means, you can contact me at steve.w@globallytraining.ca. My phone number is 780-819-9819. That's the end of the presentation, but I am going to stay on for the next little while to answer any questions that you may have. So please do feel free, put them in the chat box, fire them through. I'll do everything I can to answer the questions live right here. But if you don't have time, please do email me or follow up, and I'll be happy to provide you more examples, additional demonstrations, or show anybody else in your organization. Thank you very much. Best of luck with your online training journey, and I hope it is a big success.